Hey, I am Phil Soussan. How are you? Welcome to my home studio here, which is in sunny Las Vegas. It's not actually so much sunny as it is extremely hot right now. We're in the middle of summer, so the air conditioning is working overtime, but in here, it's cool and it's hot. So I am in the process of playing on the new Diamond KOBRA album, and my dear friend Dirk Bellau asked me to play and guest on this record, and I'm very honored and very flattered. He asked me to pick a track, and the track that I picked was a track called King Vulture. I love this track because there's lots of sequencing going on. There's dirt guitars, there's heavy stuff. There's lots of choices for different tonalities, and I wanted to pick and work out a bass part that had some drive to it and some thematic or melodic elements to it as well as just some aggression. And that's what I think I did. Anyway, I'm going to give you a little bit of a rundown of the equipment I'm using. This is a P-Bass copy. It's not a Fender, it's a custom bass. And I use this a lot. I've used this with Last in Line on all our recordings, actually. And many times when I'm looking for that kind of passive, precision bass kind of sound. Live, I use Music Man's, but in the studio sometimes there's nothing like a precision. And coming out of here, I go into a DI, a split DI, which splits into two signals. And one goes through a small Ampeg Portaflex, which I will show you, and that goes into a guitar speaker. And I particularly like using guitar speakers with small bass amplifiers in the studio because they sing better. You know, you get... great sound. It's like it just sings. Anyway, so the DI section goes through an API DI, and I use a Sans amp to modify it, but I keep the clean signal as an option as well. And then I'm going to give you a little bit of a quick rundown. So there's our DI that comes in. It goes into the 1176. From the 1176, it goes to an AP. From the 1176, it goes to the system, and the other half comes into this Ampeg Portaflex. I can't speak English anymore. And then we go into a single 12-inch guitar cabinet, mic'd up with an RE20 microphone. Classic setup, and we can see that we have three tracks there: a raw DI, an affected DI, and a cabinet. That's it. That's a little bit of a brief rundown. Sorry, I don't have a multi-camera video shoot going on here, but I just wanted to give a little bit of an overview of how I approached this. I'm very honored to play on the album and to have been asked to guest on it. So, thank you very much for that, Dirk. And I hope you like what I did. I hope the album's a tremendous success. And if you like what I did, let me know. And if you don't like what I did, then let me know. Anyway, hope you have a great day. You take care, and see you all somewhere down the road, somewhere when we get out of this COVID nonsense. Hopefully we'll be doing some shows again pretty soon. You take care. Have a good day.